Hello friends, welcome. Today I want to talk about relationships and emotional insecurities, hang-ups. Unfortunately, you know, not everybody treats everybody right, do they, on this world? And sometimes you get a partner that, you know, mistreats you or betrays you with another person or whatever it might be. And, you know, the relationship ends, whatever happens. And, you know, you're full of insecurities. So, I mean, if you stay with that partner, you're going to be forever insecure and never be able to trust them again because they've betrayed your trust that you put into them. And, you know, it's put a nail in the coffin of it, really, hasn't it? You'll probably never be able to trust that person again because you know they're not dependable or reliable. You vested your love, your time, your emotions into that person, and they've let you down. But, you know, you can get over those things and you can find trust again, you know, if you're willing to. Now, they're baggage, aren't they? Emotional hang-ups and baggage we carry around with us. It's not good because, you know, it's impaired. It's a mentality if we become emotionally untrusting, jealous, you know, unable to express our love and feelings to others. It's because we're hung up and scared of being hurt again. Now, for instance, you've been betrayed and that partner's left you, boyfriend, husband, wife, whatever it might be, girlfriend, you know, they've betrayed your trust. And, you know, you put a lot of vested emotions into a person when you have a loving relationship. And then you go into a new relationship. And if you take all that baggage that you had because you've been betrayed and become emotionally hung up, you take all that baggage onto that new relationship and don't trust that new partner just because they might betray you. And you're jealous of them if they dare look at another man or woman, whatever it is in that case. You know, you can't express your feelings to them because you're scared they're going to hurt you. You can't tell them you even love them. You know, you want to sometimes, but there's something inhibiting you inside saying, no, no, don't do that. No, they might take advantage of you if you tell them you love them. So, I mean, that again is a nail in the coffin of that new relationship, isn't it? Because you start a new relationship and you have these misgivings and, you know, stuff that you've got to try and get over before you get into that relationship. But really, you've got to wipe the slate clean with a new partner and trust them, even though you say, well, it's still possible they could betray me. Yes, but that's a chance I have to take. Because if I go into that new relationship mistrusting this person, envious of them or jealous of them, even looking at another person, I feel jealousy and, you know, anger and all kinds of mixed emotions, or I can't tell them I love them because I'm afraid they'll hurt me if I do, that, you know, you are putting a nail in the coffin of that relationship, because that person, if they love you, you know, you've got to trust them, haven't you? And they will put up with that, your hang-ups, for a while. But in the end, when you express and obviously to them that you don't trust them, and you know, you've got to trust every partner you're with, or it's ruined to begin with, because trust is the most quintessential thing you've got to have in any relationship. You've got to trust your partner and give them the benefit of the doubt. Because if you don't, it's ruined the relationship right from the beginning. And maybe you can hide your hang-ups for two or three months or a bit longer maybe, but then they're all start to become obvious to that person that you don't trust them, that you don't say you love them, that you get jealous of them if they're not even allowed to speak to somebody of the opposite gender, because, you know, you're likely to go irate at them and you know, because your insecurities of your emotions are jealous. You know, and you know, don't want them anywhere near somebody they might be attracted to. So, you know, that is going to ruin it. That person is going to turn around and be unhappy with you. And potentially it's a axe between the two of you that you're put in there because you're emotionally hung up. And it'll end that relationship probably sooner or later. It'll never be a happy one because you're never giving them the things that they absolutely do need from you in a proper equal partnership. And that is, they need you to trust them and they need you to love them and they need you to be, you know, and not jealous of them because you trust them, of course. So, you know, you've got to, you know, fight those little demons, because Although logically, our logical mind can say to our emotions, don't worry about this, it'll be all right, sort of thing. Emotions become quite obscure when they've been hurt and very insecure. And that's what it is. That's why you don't trust. That's why you're jealous. That's why you can't say you love somebody, because you're insecure and frightened, fearful of being hurt emotionally again, because it really knocks you back when it did happen to you. And it's given you emotional hang-ups and baggage that you're carrying around and that you can potentially carry into a new relationship, and which will wreck it, So we have to try to reason our way out of these things. And, when you find a new partner, you can be open with them and say, I've been a little insecure about a past relationship because I was betrayed. I need you to tell me I can trust you. I need you to assure me you're not going to betray me. I need you to, understand, where I've been, and that I need your understanding of these things and such like, so that new partner can give you the reassurances to some degree. The rest of the journey is really yours to make, to help your emotions to understand, listen, you can't be like this. You can't be untrusting. We've got to give this new person a clean start, and have no misgivings about them, because you can't bring the baggage of that past relationship onto this new one. So we give them a clean slate, and they might betray us, maybe, but that's the chance we have to take. And that's the truth. Every relationship between two people, especially on this level of evolution of the earth plane, people are not so progressed. They make mistakes. They go off and do things that are maybe not good to do sometimes. And, that's the chance we have to take on this world. I'm afraid that we've got to take the chance, hang up our hang ups and leave them behind, because it's a lesson and experience. This world to learn from. But when it starts making you mentally obscure, because you can't keep control of these things and they're haunting you, these emotions and such like, then of course we've got to learn to be able to put our own mind back into the right harmony and balance and state that it needs to be in to continue and, get over that hurt and what's been done to you and leave it behind where it belongs. It was an experience you learnt from. But it's like many things, you can overcome it and get beyond it and not let it inhibit and affect your life anymore, so that you can get on and have a decent and loving and trusting new relationship. So hard to do sometimes to reason with emotions, because they don't always act on reason, because they're feelings, aren't they? But you can help to put them back into order. It just takes a process of going through things and finding that security, because they're insecure, of course. So do what you can with a new partner to find that security, and tell them, look, I've got insecurities. I need you to help me feel secure, and, because I want to trust you and I want to have a clean slate. So anyway, love and light to you, Neil.